Hello ma'am, we are honored to have you here. We would like to ask you a few questions that are in our mind regarding the nutrition value of the food that is being provided at our school. The very first question is, what are the nutrition requirements of a school lunch?
Okay. So the nutrition requirements of a school lunch has to be extremely balanced. And ideally, 1/3 of the total day's food intake should come from a lunch, because that's obviously 1/3 of the main meals. So that could incorporate everything, right, from adequate energy, adequate carbohydrates, good amount of fiber, protein, good quality fat, and a very special attention to a few nutrients, which is calcium, iron, zinc, because obviously it's a growing child. So we obviously have a number of special attention to these specific micronutrients and the macronutrients.
Thank you so much. The next question is, what elements should be considered when developing a school lunch?
So the elements which has to be considered should be that it has to be an entire school lunch, which as I said, balanced, coming from all the food groups. So if I talk about cereals, so let's say gehu and rice is a part of your cereal group. We have vegetables, so obviously we give a lot of variety of vegetables. We are very rich with our Indian sources and local vegetables, so we incorporate as much as we can. Protein, which comes from dal, rajma, chole, chana. And we also provide salads, and we also provide some appetizers, which is nothing but a chutney. So this, because the entire meal becomes a complete meal. And for salad, we have given raita, we give sometimes chas, we give sometimes a chana and a cucumber salad. Variation, where all the food groups are taken into consideration, which is your cereals, your pulses, nuts and oils. Sometimes we do provide peanuts as well. And obviously your protein, which comes from your milk and milk products and your general pulses.
The third question is, how do you monitor food safety and sanitation?
So food safety and sanitation is a very challenging task for such a huge population, and it's a very big mess for us. So I would say random checks, one. B, we definitely make sure that the entire organized setup for it. So basically, as right from serving to the meals, to covering your hands, to covering your mouth while the person is cooking, to covering the head, having headgears for everyone working in the mess, to right from just like as simple as providing sanitizing methods and some right techniques to the workers. We also provide once in 6 months a deworming tablet to the workers, so that obviously we take care of their health also. So looking at the basic foundation, we just do simple measures for these employees, so we take care of their health so they can be the best of provision for also providing better safety and hygiene to the workers.
The fourth question and the last one is,
yes.
How do you provide training to the workers who are working in the mess?
So we do have, in general, periodic training for the employees, which could be just simple talking to them, what could be the hindrances, what happens while they're working on the specific kitchen areas, which could be, let's say, they get cut by a knife, or as simple as, ye cover nahi ho sakta hai, or we don't have this adequate utensils. So we look at these small, basic, ongoing hindrances, and thereby provide, okay, this can be solved in this particular manner. Or B, we tell them to obviously wear adequate clothing, chop their nails. So I do a random check every few weeks where we're looking that, okay, the nails are actually perfectly done. The hair is perfectly chopped. So very basic, and also they also provide extremely clean utensils. So we obviously do that every few weeks. We have like an entire cleaning area where we are doing the utensils again, where we are doing the storage equipment again, in terms of cleaning and sanitizing.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It's a privilege having you here.
Thank you.